I want to welcome you as the pastor of the church here and those that are watching online. Thank you for coming. Thank you for supporting the family. And we are here to celebrate the life of Jeremiah John Campbell. And I was thinking as I was standing back there that the sovereign God of this universe decided to create Jeremiah in his image, in his likeness, and he is a unique individual. There's not been somebody exactly like him before, and there's not going to be anybody exactly like him after. And I think that fact implores us today that we celebrate the life that God had chosen to give to Jeremiah. And I do want to thank you as friends and family to be here for one another, to support one another, not just today, but in the days to come. And at this time, the family has asked to celebrate the life, so we're going to do that, and I'll go ahead and open us up in prayer. Heavenly Father, gracious God, we're thankful that you saw fit to create Jeremiah in your image and your likeness, to give him life. Give him life that those in this room and those online were able to share and be a part of that. And so, Lord, we do come to you today in celebration and thankfulness. We lay our cares upon your feet. We recognize, Lord, that you are a good and gracious God and you bring about healing. So I pray that your healing touch will be upon the family. And I pray, Lord, that you would just guide this time as we give you thanks, as we celebrate and even grieve our loss, Lord. And we give you praise, we give you thanks, and surrender this time to you. It's in your Son's name we pray. Amen.
Jeremiah was a friend, a brother, a father, and a son. I promised I wasn't going to do this. Jeremiah was my firstborn. He brought joy into my life, and I know that he brought joy into many other people's lives. He was a very gifted musician and a very gifted carpenter. I remember in high school he played the bassoon, and one of the counselors, the teachers there, said that he doesn't remember anybody playing the bassoon as good as he did. And he could have basically written his ticket to go to any college that he wanted to, but Jeremiah had different plans, and decided not to follow that, but he did play the guitar, and he was very gifted on the guitar, and I know he brought joy and peace to a lot of people through his music. Jeremiah was also gifted with his hands. He was a very good carpenter. He helped us at one time build the inside of a bus to make a camper. He was able to build a business with his carpentry skills. He sent me a picture one time of a porch that he had done. He was really so proud of it, and I was so proud of him for it, too. He did a beautiful job on it. Jeremiah was a father, and he loved his son. I remember when Owen was born, he stayed home to take care of him. He was kind of like a stay-at-home dad. I know he loved his son very much. When Jeremiah was a toddler, he was so funny with some of his antics. He had one day I remember him crawling underneath the counter, standing up, hit his head. He turned around and looked at me and like, "Do I cry? What do I do?" And I looked at him and I said, "Did Did you hurt yourself? Of course, he couldn't talk. And I says, well, you're not supposed to stand up underneath the table. So he'd get out, and he'd go and do it again. And it was like, okay. The second time, though, he never cried. It was like, oh, I hit my head. Now what do I do? He was so funny. Boys have a tendency to not call their parents, especially their moms. And I told him there were three very important dates that he had to call his mom. I told this to all my boys. Three very important dates. On Mother's Day, on Christmas, and on my birthday. You think he did it? No, he didn't. But I know he still loved me. And so I would call him. I'd call him and, you know, talk to him. How you doing? Doing good, Mom. Okay. He would tell me what was going on with Owen and what's going on with his life. And we had a really good conversation the Friday before he passed away. And he sounded like things were going really, really well. And he was talking to me about some decisions that he wanted to make. And what do you think, Mom? And I said, I think that's great. You know, just follow your heart and do what God wants you to do. And that was the last time I spoke with him. I know I'm going to miss him very much.
A secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do ya? Well, it goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Cut your hair, and from your lips she drew the hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. To understand how this could be part of his plan, when all the pains of grief are shooting through ya. But one thing I can say for sure, the suffering, it is no more, when the King of Kings and our Father singing over you. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Thank you. Wasn't that good? Praise the Lord. I'm Jeremiah's father. And I've thought many times over the last few weeks, what could I say? You know, he was his own man. And he made decisions based on what was best for him. As he got older, he wanted to go to work for Chrysler at one point. Same company I'm retiring from this coming week. And he went through all the testing, all of the little things that they put you through to see if you can do the work, and he passed. And he was going to go to work for Chrysler. And I thought, oh, finally, a path that he can take that will be steady. Don't have to worry about working so hard, trying to make a living. But when it came down to the decision of whether he would do that, no, he had his own path. And he wanted to be what he became, a carpenter and a work for himself. He didn't want to work for anybody. How many knew that about him? He was the kind of guy that, you know, seemed to not be sure where he was at. He was a little younger, and I remember Rose helped him to, he was in love with several girls as he was younger, and she helped him. I don't know if any of you remember Marla, Postel, but at one point he was madly infatuated, and Rose helped him. One point, I don't know if she'd like to share that story, but but he had his own way about him, and he wasn't too sure about girls at some point, but he needed help. And he came to Rose and said, what can I do to influence her? Invited her to dinner at my house, and might have been a mistake. I think everybody got sick. But he came up through Royal Rangers, and he loved it. I don't know how honest he was, but he did his best to do the camping and get out in the wilderness and learn some of the skills of being a frontiersman eventually. And his brother Josh was the same way. They loved those activities. And yeah, we had fun with axes and black powder and knife throwing and all of that stuff. And God was good, because those were good days. And I remember both of them told me as they got older, they said, you know, you weren't always there, but when you were, we had a ball. We went and did things that all the time. They were out there camping, swimming, fishing, things that, you know, manly men stuff, as some would say. And they loved it, and they did it. Did it with gusto. So we celebrate doing some things with gusto. That's why we're here today. Those that have showed up, thank you. Some of you I don't even know, but God bless you. And we appreciate the fact that you've come out to be a part of this. And we pray that you'll be blessed. Owen, we love you. Don't know you enough, but we love you. And there's going to be good things for your life in spite of a loss. He's a loss to all of us, but his life speaks louder than words. So thank you. Thank you for coming out today.
I'm not that tall, so once again, this isn't easy. Jeremiah, thank you. Thank you for being my older brother. Jeremiah taught me to follow and taught me how to be a leader. Taught me how to ride a bike.
He showed you how to break your arm, too.
Yeah. I remember that.
As my mom said, he had to figure things out first, so when he bumped his head, he told me what to say when I bumped mine. So, Jeremiah taught me to be a stronger person. I'm thankful for that. I'm going to switch gears here just a little bit. On behalf of Paul Smith, Paul is a good friend that Jeremiah met. I'm just going to share a little bit of a story from him. Jeremiah met Paul in a time of need, and Paul needed Jeremiah's woodworking skills. This mutual exchange quickly turned to a lasting friendship. Paul spoke to me on the phone and described a memory of Jeremiah. Not sure if it was from his dog Shadow, but one of the dogs he had, Jeremiah would do a karate move where he'd spin and go backwards, and he would freeze, and the dog would freeze with him. And as soon as he would spin, the dog would spin too. So Jeremiah and Owen would set up boxes in his basement, run the matchbox cars down it. Paul said it was great times. They would also play Legos and, of course, video games, too. As we were growing up, we were talking about this last night, we had two five-gallon pails of Legos. I don't know if anybody's ever stepped on Legos at night, but my poor mom. So, yeah, we We were fun. It was good. We didn't have very much growing up, but we had each other. As both parents have alluded, Jeremiah was a hard-headed individual. He did not like taking orders from anyone. This is why he was better working for himself. He was a great musician, and he could play a mean guitar. He also played the drums and sang. Jeremiah enjoyed video games, which has passed along to his son Owen as well, and we were playing today, in fact. Although our time here on earth is no more his time, we will be reunited in heaven and continue the laughter and fun. I'm going to open this up. Would anybody else like to say anything here this morning? Is this Chad? Who's behind you? Oh, that's your friend. Okay. Jeremiah had a friend, Chad, that said he might be here. I just was asking about that. Anybody want to say anything more about Jeremiah? If not, I'm going to turn back over to the Ben Judas.
Hello, anybody out there? I want to share a little bit about Jeremiah, my stepdad, Al. One of the greatest times that I had with Jeremiah was we went to Stuckey's candy store here in, what was it, Tampa? Wildwood. Okay. Anyway, Owen was there. Oh, and you might remember this because your dad taught you a really good lesson in that store. He really embarrassed the donkey out of me. They went around, they had all these vendor things. You open up the bottom, fill your bag with the candy, and take it up, and you don't pay for it. Well, Jeremiah had another plan. Yes, he had his own agenda. Him and Owen went around, put their head down, and sampled every candy in that store. And I said, Jeremiah, they got cameras in here, dude. I'm afraid to go up the cash register with you. But it was fun. They had a great time. Jeremiah was doing this for almost an hour, sampling these candies. And his poor mother's, you know, putting the candy in the basket and getting ready to check out. And they never said a thing. They never said anything about this guy going around sucking all the candy out of the vendors. But anyway, that was the best time I ever had with him. And yes, he was a good musician. He was a good kid. He had his own agenda, but he was not a dummy. He was very smart and very gifted. We're going to miss him a lot, and there's no doubt.
Lord bless you and keep you, and make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. the Lord bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon you, and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children and their children and their children. May his presence go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you and within you. He is with you. He is with you in the morning, in the evening, in your coming, in your going, in your weeping and rejoicing. He is for you. He is for you. He is for you. He is for you.
That song was the prayer. Lord bless you, may keep you, may his face shine upon you. Heavenly Father, thank you. Thank you that you gave us the opportunity to share Jeremiah's life. We recognize he's in your hands now. Father, may you bless and keep each one here. May your face.